Hey everyone, it's Mike Ball from WordPress.com, and today we're going to look at the group block. This block has been used more with full site editing, specifically within templates and block patterns, but there wasn't really an explanation of how exactly it works that came out with it. You don't usually get a manual for these types of things. So we're going to cover quickly how it works and what it does, and then why it might be beneficial to you, depending on what you're working on. So I'm starting with the simple layout. I found some really cool illustrations from Openverse for Star Wars characters that I like. So what I did is kind of put like a collector card together with different information. So we have his name, a short little bio, and some character attributes. So as you would expect, these are just different blocks stacked. So if we look at the list view here, we have the image, heading, paragraph, another heading, and columns, which is actually how it's laid out. Now, if I drop this in a page with other content, I have to keep all these things together. Which you can see right now, I have all of them selected. I can select one by one. If I click one and I hold shift, I can click the bottom one and select them as a group. But I have to remember how all those go together every time I want to adjust anything. So to avoid doing that and avoid having to recreate it one by one by one, what we can do is just add a group block in here, and then I'm actually going to drag it to the top because I like to organize things up that way. So what you're going to see is that little placeholder, and I'm going to start just dropping one thing at a time. Now if I expand, you'll see this little arrow popped up, so I can expand this group block, and you'll see in here that the image is actually indented compared to the other items. So that's how you know that that block is in the group that you're working on. So if I just want to drag these in, so if I go normally, that little pink line in the background will go full width. If I move it to the right a little bit, it'll go indent. So then I know that I'm dropping it in that group. So see that heading right there, I dropped it before that line was full. If I move it over, it's in the group. I'll go up here, do the same thing. If I collapse it, all the blocks are gone. So now, it doesn't look like much in this page because this is the content on there, but if you're working on a page with multiple sections and patterns and all that, you can see the benefit to being able to keep a clean space. The other benefit to using this is that if I just want to create a new character card, for example, I can just duplicate that entire group, and then I can just change out the information. So you can see I have two of them now. They're exactly the same, but it's much faster to take that and change the content instead of recreating every single block. So when I was working on this, So these are really cool illustrations in here. Let's say I want to put in Yoda. You can see it's pretty quick to change some of these. I can write more. I can change all the stats, and then I have two different cards. And that's a faster way to build content. It's a faster way to keep different pieces of content together and build more complex content. And it's a faster way to scale out your work so you don't have to redo every single block. So I'm going to play around with this a little bit, and then we're going to come back and look at some other layout blocks.